Hello everyone, I'm Nianliu from Beijing University of Post and Telecommunications, and I'm very glad to share a new work with you. The title is Compact Graph Structured Learning via Mutual Information Comprehension. And today, my presentation mainly includes four parts: the introduction, the proposed model CoachESL, some experiments, and finally, some conclusions. Now the first, the introduction. As we know that graph neural network has been a standard tool to handle the graph data because of its unique message passing technique, a famous framework graph convolutional network is shown here. We know that the performance of graph neural network heavily depends on the quality of the given structure, but the structure are not always reliable in real applications. Like for some reasons, like no prior structure in neural language processing or computer vision, and some fake edges may be injected into the structure, and the structure sometimes suffer from heavy attack, and therefore some studies have focused on the problem of graph structured learning or GSL. Generally speaking, GSL aims to learn an optimal graph structure and the parameters of graph neural network at the same time. And in this paper, we roughly divide the existing methods into two classes. The first one is single-wheel-based methods. These methods directly use the given structure with some additional regularizations to constrain the learned structure to meet some special conditions. And the representative method is ProGN. And the second one is multi-wheel-based methods. These methods can use many wheels from the original structure and combine them to give a comprehensive direct decision about the final wheel. Therefore, they can use multi-faced knowledge, and we mainly focus on these methods in this paper. As I introduced at the last slide, we give a sketch of the multi-wheel-based graph structure learning. Again, two basic wheels, V1 and V2, are extracted from the original dataset D, and then they are fused into the final wheel V-star. And GN is given to include the final wheel with star. The whole pipeline is optimized with the label YL. So in the whole pipeline, the most fundamental question is how to obtain an optimal structure. In this paper, we define the optimal structure must be a concise one. That's to say, the V-star must include and only include the information about the label Y without any other information useless. In this figure, different color means the information about different variables. You can see that the information of V-star is very close to that of label Y. We call this concise structure as a minimal sufficient structure. Since V-stars include all of the information about Y, it can give an effective prediction. Meantime, if perturbation occurs in V1 and V2, the V1 will not be heavily affected. Therefore, it's a robust structure. As below, we give a formal definition about minimal sufficient structure. In this definition, we use some terms in the information theory, like the mutual information between V star and the label YL. That's to say the shared information between them, and the entropy of YL, the total information of the label, and the conditional entropy. Given YL, the entropy of V star. These two conditions say that V star and YL only share the information about YL and accept the information of label. V star doesn't include any other information. And next, we design a model called CodeGSL to obtain such a minimal sufficient structure. The overall architecture is shown here. The model mainly includes three parts: two basic wheel estimator, and adaptive fusion. Now, the first one is the selection of basic wheels. We all know that a good beginning is half done. Therefore, it is very important for us to select two basic wheels. On the right hand, we list the four wheels for the choice. The first one is adjacency metric, is for the local structure. And the second one is diffusion metric, and depicts the global view of the structure. And for some large graph, we choose to use the subgraph sampling to generate the basic view. And finally, the KNN graph is calculated by the node features, which is used to describe the similarity between nodes in the feature space. And then we design a view estimator to modify the basic wheels to make them more flexible. For the basic wheel V1, we use a JSON to get the node embedding under this wheel Z1. We concat the embeddings of node I and G and get the importance between them by a MLP. And then we normalize all the importance to get the probability. And finally, we combine the learned probability metric and the original basic wheel V1 with the coefficient mu1 to get the estimated wheel VES1. And VES2 can be obtained in a similar way. And then we need to think how to effectively fill these two estimated wheels to generate the final wheel with star. In this part, we assign a larger weight to the more confident wheel, and we think the more sharper the predict distribution is, the more confident it is. If the confident wheel assigned with a larger weight, it will dominate the fusion, and the final wheel with star will also be a confident wheel, which is conducive to the training. First, we will get the prediction of two wheels, O1 and O2, and then we calculated the importance pi for each wheel respectively. Here, we show the importance pi for wheel 1 for the node I. In this equation, epsilon and lambda are two hyperparameters, and OIM1 means the max value of the prediction, and OISM1 means the second max value of the prediction. So in this equation, we think that if a prediction have a higher max value and a larger margin between mask and the second mask value, it will be a more confident wheel. And next, we can get the pi I1 and pi I2 through this equation. And next, we average them to get the importance of each wheel, beta I1 and beta I2, and we use these two importance to fuse to estimated wheels and generate and get the final structure with star. It should be noticed that in this fusion, we choose to adaptive fuse for each node, and we don't involve any new learnable parameters. And now we have got the final structure with star. The next question is, how can we do to guarantee the with star is a minimal sufficient structure? Let's record the definition of minimal sufficient structure. We should with star include and only include the information about while. Here we give a proposition to achieve this goal. This proposition mainly includes two conditions. The first one is the mutual information between VES1, VES2, VSTAR, and YL all equal to the entropy of YL. That's to say, these two and these three wheels all include all of the information of the label YL. And then with this with condition one, we need the mutual information between every two wheels minimized, like the conditional two. With these two conditions, we can with these two conditions, we can let the final structure we start be a minimal sufficient structure. The relative proof is given in the paper. The next question is how to estimate mutual information between wheels. Here we use the inference NCE loss, which is widely used in the contrastive learning. There's a connection between inference NCE loss and mutual information. If we optimize the inference NCE loss, we can capture the real value of the mutual information, and the loss is shown here. Okay, and finally, we comprehend all of the optimizations into this threefold optimization. We first optimize the classifiers for each wheel, and then we optimize the mutual information estimator to capture the real value of the mutual information between each two wheels. And finally, we optimize the wheel estimator by this objective. This objective says that we should minimize the information between every two wheels, but they still can perform well. Okay, the experimental part. We use 7 datasets and compare with 3 kinds of baselines. And we do 2 tasks, node classification and defense performance under attacks to verify the effectiveness and the robustness of our proposed model. Now the first is the results of the node classification. You can see that our proposed model, CoGSL, outperforms the SOTA methods on all data sets. And then we we test the defense performance under the random edge deletion and the edge addition. Please note that our CoGSL starts from 2 basic wheels. Therefore, we choose to protect one of these two wheels and attack both of them simultaneously. Therefore, we have 3 results of our models, CoGSL V1, V2, or CoGSL all. You can see that 3 of our methods are all robust than other compared methods, which show that CoGSL can approach the minimal sufficient structure, and so it can define the attack. And finally, let's draw some conclusions. In this paper, we propose the concept minimal sufficient structure, the most compact structure relevant to downstream tasks in principle, no more and no less. And we theoretically prove that how to gain minimal sufficient structure and propose CoGSL to learn it via mutual information comprehension. And finally, we do extensive experiments to verify the effectiveness and the robustness of CoGSL. Thank you, that's all for my presentation. Here are some information about this work, and here is our official account. Welcome to join us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for this nice presentation. So we have Nian Liu with us to answer questions. I see in the chat already people are active. So I'm going to take your questions if that's okay with everybody. Hongrui Liu asks, first of all, how do you decide between the two candidates that will be used as basic views? And this is a bit my question too, like would the approach also work for multiple views at once?
Yeah, okay. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I think that's a good question. Actually, for each data set, we will test all 4 wheels for it. For example, adjacency metric, diffusion metric, subgraph, or KNN graph. And we select the wheels which have better performance among these 4 wheels. For my experience, for some small graphs, diffusion metric is usually the best view. But because the diffusion metric is also a dense metric, it cannot be used in large graph. For the huge consumption of the space or time, so we have to use subgraph sampling as for the large graph. Yeah, that's my answer.
Okay, thank you. And Hongrui Liu further asks, what is the difference between the infomin and the minimal sufficient structure? So the infomin principle from contrastive learning.
Oh, okay, I can see the question. Oh, yes, I think that's also a good question. I know the principle, and it is proposed in the contrastive learning. I think both infomin principle and our minimal sufficient structure are all from the minimal sufficient statistic in information theory. Infomin principle, I think, is to constrain the relationship between two data augmentations in contrastive learning. But in our paper, the minimal sufficient structure is to constrain the relationship between the final structure V star and the downstream labels YL. So in our minimal sufficient structure, there's a relation between the label which is not existed in the contrastive learning. But again, I think both of us are inspired by the same idea, and that's minimal sufficient statistic in information theory. Okay.